Hi there, Elisa here with the Perot Museum. No, my phone's not broken. I'm outside stargazing. Space is one of my favorite topics in science. Outer space is incredible. When I'm home, I like to sit on my patio, or sometimes I'll go to a nearby park and I'll stargaze. Now, I live in the city, so the amount of light on the ground from streets and buildings means I can't really see as much as I could if I lived farther outside the city or drove to a much darker area. But even so, you can spot some amazing things, and I have a few tools that help me do so. First, I use what's called a planisphere, but I'll tell you more about that in a second. I use a red flashlight to help me see in the dark, and sometimes I'll use a stargazing app I've downloaded to my phone. I even borrowed some friends' binoculars. Planispheres, or star wheels, are really simple stargazing tools. Make sure you get one that's for your part of the world where you live. If you look around the edge, you'll see dates and times. Line up today's date with whatever time you're going stargazing. And then make sure you're facing the right direction. Whether it's north, or east, or south, or west, the window above will show you the stars in that part of the sky so that you can learn more about them. But if you can't order a star wheel, maybe you can make your own. My friend Jessica here, she printed one off of our own website. This is a star wheel that NASA helped create. All you need to make it are scissors and some tape. Humans don't have very good night vision, so if you're just using your star wheel, make sure you use a red flashlight because, phones are super bright, and red light is much gentler on our eyes. It takes about 20 minutes for our eyes to adjust to the darkness. Now, if you don't have a printer at home but you do have a smartphone, maybe you can download a stargazing app like I did. They usually have night settings to help with your night vision, and they teach you all about stars, constellations, and planets. There's Jupiter, Saturn, and Mars over there. Sometimes you can even spot the International Space Station where astronauts work, or even the Hubble telescope. Hubble is 30 years old this year. Happy birthday, Hubble. It's been taking such beautiful pictures for us. Now let's see, we're in the southwestern sky. So that means that Sirius is right there. Sirius is one of the brightest stars in our night sky. It's 8.6 light years away. That's over 51 trillion miles. And next to it is the Orion constellation. Orion has those three bright stars in his belt. One, two, three. All right, if we keep going, we'll find Venus. Venus is close to our moon right now. And Venus is one of the brightest things in our night sky besides the moon itself. Sometimes you can even see Venus before the sun completely sets. And there's our moon. It's a crescent moon today. Hi, moon. All right, what else can we spot? Let's keep going around the horizon. Actually, there's our sun. Our sun is already below the horizon along with Mercury because they've already set for the day. All right, if we go back to our north part of our sky, we'll find the Little Dipper, or Ursa Minor, the little bear. And at the end of his tail is Polaris. Polaris is our north star, and humans have used Polaris to study the stars and to navigate the world for thousands of years. There's so much more in outer space for us to explore. Between NASA, observatories all around the world, astronomy clubs in cities maybe near you, and scientists like you in their own backyard. We learn new things every day about this amazing universe we live in. So, grab a blanket, grab your stargazing tools, maybe some tasty snacks, and some good company, and see what you can see. Who knows, maybe you'll spot a new galaxy out there. Let us know, and we'll see you next time on Amaze Your Brain at Home. Bye!
If I do screen record,
yeah, they don't have a schedule for like,
does it
if
go?
It's delayed like a week for the US.
Oh no, I'm doing selfie record. That's not what I want.